So from next class we'll go on with Google Meet only. So there was some problem today due to which I connected back to the Zoom. So we'll be back in Google Meet only for the other classes. So others kindly join in. Okay, so we got all the corners. So after this we darkened the top surface also. So then you just as which lines are visible, same thing you replicated, no difference. Only the thing is axis is shifted to 40 degree. So after this, others ask them to kindly join immediately, put a message in the WhatsApp. Okay, so here what happens is you will join from E2 E1 and B2 B1. Remaining sites were already been joined. So now we have shifted the given problem to 40 degree to VP, means the axis is inclined 40 degree to VP. So after that we will take the projections above from each corner. You should be very careful in taking the projection from each corner. Okay, if you miss anything also it will be difficult. So now the projection from E1, you will extend the projection from D1, the projection from C1, the projection from B1, the projection from A1, the projection from F1, and the projection from O1. So after extending, you will extend the projection also from the top surface. So this is our A. You will extend the projection from B, so from F, so from E, so from D, and from C. So you extended all the projections from each points. So after you extend all the projections, you will extend the projection from the front view also. So please take the projections from C dash and D dash, B dash and E dash, A dash and F dash, C dash and D1 dash, B dash and E1 dash, A1 dash and F1 dash also. So after taking the projections, now you should read the locus very carefully. So here you can see the locus of E1 is meeting E1 dash at this point. So you name this as E1 dash. The locus of D1 is meeting D1 dash at this point. So this is our D1 dash. The locus of C1 is meeting C1 dash at this point. So this is our C1 dash. The locus of B1 is meeting B1 dash at this point. So this is our B1 dash. The locus of A1 is meeting A1 dash at this point. So this is our A1 dash. And locus of F1 is meeting F dash at this point. So this is our F1 dash. So we now named all the sites over here, right, of the bottom surface. Don't darken it, just do the naming. Then you please go for the top surface. So the locus of A is meeting A dash at this point, write it as A dash. The locus of B is meeting B dash at this point, so please write it as B dash. The locus of F is meeting F dash at this point, so please write it as F dash. The locus of E is meeting E dash at this point, so please write it as E dash. The locus of D is meeting D dash at this point, so please write it as D dash. And the locus of F is meeting F dash at this point, so please write it as F dash. So this is the top surface of the hexagonal prism and this is the bottom surface. So we have named it. So before drawing, I told you always the outer boundary will be visible. So before going to that, don't forget to show the center. So O1 is passing through O1 dash at this point. So this will be our O1 dash. Similarly, O is meeting O1 dash at this point. So this is our O dash. So after naming all, always the outer boundary of the hexagonal prism. So when it has been inclined, the top surface will be visible and the outer boundaries of the hexagonal prism will be visible. So always you will draw the outer boundaries to be visible. So you will join from A1 dash to A dash, A dash to B dash, B dash to C dash, C dash to D dash, D dash to D1 dash, D1 dash to A1 dash, A1 dash to, sorry, D1 dash to E1 dash, E1 dash to C1 dash, and from C1 dash to A1 dash. Okay, so you will join this. So after joining the outer boundary, so now you should see which are visible and which are not visible. So when the observer, so here in the second stage, the observer views from the top. So top surface is visible. So in the third stage, the observer views from here. So when he views from here, this surface will be in which direction he is viewing. So this surface will be visible. So you will please darken this entire surface. Okay, so A1 dash to F1 dash, F1 dash to E1 dash, E1 dash to D1 dash, D1 dash to C1 dash, and C1 dash to B1 dash, you will darken it. So once you do the darkening, so then you have to understand, so which are the other parts which are visible. So I told you, once you draw the, always draw the top surface first, which is visible, then we will carry forward with the remaining. So I told you the projections coming through the corner of the surface through which it has been viewed will be visible. So these are the four corners, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So the projection coming through the corner of the top surface will be visible. So you will draw the projection line from, so you will darken A1 dash to A dash. Outer boundary we have darkened already. So this we have to darken. B1 dash to B dash you have to darken. C1 dash to C dash you have to dark. And D1 dash to D dash is darkened already. So this part is over. So now we have to see which are the sides which are passing through inside the surface, in which direction it is viewed. So it is viewed from in this direction. So these are the projection passing through the corner of the top surface, and you have two more projections here which are passing through inside the surface. So this is E1 dash to E, and this is F1 dash to F. So these are the two sides of the hexagonal prism which are passing through inside the surface of the hexagonal prism. So this line now will be hidden. So you will draw a hidden line from E1 dash to E1, and again from F1 dash to F. So after that, the projections coming through the hidden line will be hidden line only. So this E dash is connected to F dash also. So this also will be hidden. And again, this point is connected to one more base edge. So which is F dash and A dash. So you will join F dash and A dash. This also will be hidden. And again, you will join E dash to D dash. This also will be hidden. So this is how the final stage of the front view in an hexagonal prism looks like when the given problem is inclined to VP with respect to the axis, and again inclined to VP with respect to its axis at 45 degree and 40 degree. Okay, so if it was directly inclination, then we would have determined the apparent angle here. Since the axis appears to be inclined, we will just shift the apparent length to the given 40 degree to VP. And also that the hidden lines what you have drawn here could be cross-checked with the hidden lines what you have drawn. I have told you always the projections coming through the hidden sides or the edges will be hidden over here also, provided if they are not on the outer boundary. So this is F1 dash. So the point through F1 dash and A dash is at the outer boundary. So this cannot be hidden. And again, F dash is connected to E1 dash. This is at the outer boundary. This cannot be hidden. But you have one more projection from F1 dash to F dash, which is inside the given solid prism. And as a result, this will be hidden. Similarly, if you take it for A1 dash, the projection through A1 dash is across the outer boundary. So you cannot show the hidden part. One more hidden line is A1 dash to B1 dash. So A1 and B1. So if you take the projection from B1, so all the projections of the point B1 dash here is at the outer boundary. B1 dash to B dash, B dash to C dash, B dash to A dash. And hence all these three cannot be hidden. So you can cross check like this after you complete the front view. The main concept is always the outer boundary will be visible. So in which direction it is viewed, the top surface will be visible. So in this case, it is a top surface. If it is viewed in this direction, this is the surface through which it is viewed. So this will be totally visible. And any projection coming through inside the surface in the direction it is viewed, it will be hidden. And the projections coming through the corner of the top surface will be always visible, so that you will make it visible. And you can cross check with the top view hidden lines whether it is mapping properly or not. And in the last, you have to show the axis. Don't forget, you have the marks for that also. So the projection from O1 is meeting O1 dash at this point. So this will be our O1. And projection of O is meeting O dash at this point. So this will be our O. And later you can join these two using projection line. No need to darken it. And always the axis line here will be parallel to any of the edges what you have drawn. Okay, so for all the longer edges, the axis what you have drawn will be parallel if you have constructed properly. If you are getting axis line inclined to some angle, so then you have gone wrong in taking either the projection or marking the axis from O1 to O properly. So this is how you have to solve the problem in hexagonal prism when the given prism, when the hexagonal prism is resting on one of its edge. And in the second stage, the axis is inclined to 45 degree and the axis appears to be inclined to 40 degree to VP. If it was directly inclined to VP, then we would have determined the apparent angle. So this is about the problem. Similarly, we will try to solve one more problem related to our beta angle. The same thing what we did it. Only thing here, the axis was appeared to be inclined to 40 degree to VP. And in this case, the axis is inclined to VP directly at 30 degree. In that case, we have to determine the apparent angle. So it is again an hexagonal prism of 25 mm side. You have to see what is the axis height. The axis height is also same, which is 50 mm. Then you have to check it out how it is resting. It is resting on one of its edges. Either edges or the side remains the same. If it is told it is resting on one of its side or one of its edge, always you keep that side or edge towards your right. And in the hexagonal, always you get the opposite side here, because hexagon has six sides. So you will get, if you fix one side towards your right, the other vertical side will be deadly opposite to it. Then only it shows you have constructed properly. If it is resting on one of its corner, then you will show the corner towards the right and you will be having one more corner towards your left. Since the problem is resting on one of its edge, first you will keep one of the edge on towards your right. So the opposite edge will be here. And you know the top and the bottom surface, you will be having two pentagonal surface. So you will name it as A, B, C, D, E, F at the top, A1, B1, C1, D1, E1 and F1 in the bottom. Bottom surface will not be visible, so you will write it in the bracket. Same thing as I explained you, top surface and bottom surface, A, B, C, D, E, A1, B1, C1, D1 and E1. So which is hidden? The bottom surface parameters. So I'll keep it in the bracket. Then as usual, you'll take the projection above. The axis height is 50 mm. I'm not stressing much because stage 1 and stage 2 is same. So you'll take the projection above and construct the front view. And then axis is inclined to 45 degree. So you'll shift the, so you'll draw an axis line of 45 degree, shift the entire front view to the second stage. See that the corner is lying exactly on corner of, one of the corner of the base lies exactly on XY line. In that way you will construct it and you show 45 degree to HP. Then you take the projections down from each corners. Don't forget, and I also extend the projection from each point from the top view and read the locus and do the naming as I told in the last problem. And cover the outer boundary first, because the outer boundary of the solid will be visible. So once it is visible, then you will, when the observer views from the top will be visible. So the top surface you will darken first. Then the projection coming through the corner of the top surface will be visible. So you will darken those. Apart from that, you have a corner on XY line, so the projection coming through that corner will be hidden. So you'll make this edge, and this edge hidden. And also told the projection coming through inside the surface will be hidden. Okay, so this is the top surface. So projection coming through inside the top surface will be hidden. So you will join these two lines as hidden line. So this I have completed in depth in the previous problem. So I've just brushed out. So only thing what you have to focus is how to determine the apparent angle, because it is told the axis is directly inclined to VP at 30 degree. So first what you do is, normally you take 30 degree line. So after take 30 degree line, you have to check. You can see here the true length of the axis is 50 mm. So when it is measured, the apparent length of the axis what you are getting from O to O1 is just 35.36. Always the apparent length will be smaller than that of our true length. So what we do here, first you take 30 degree to VP. So once you take 30 degree to VP, you have to fix either O or O1. Please don't fix the point very near to XY line, because you have to shift the entire top view here below XY line. So leave some distance. So this is our 30 degree line. Leave some distance and fix the point O. So once you fix the point O, you please measure the true length, how much it is, 50 mm, using the compass. Come back here, keep one end of the compass at O, and you measure exactly 50 mm and cut an arc on 30 degree line. Okay, so now you got the true length from O to O1. If you measure and check, it will be exactly equal to 50 mm. So later, where it meets, you please name it immediately as O1, or else you will get confused. So once you name O1 and O, please draw the locus through O1. After drawing the locus through O1, come back to the second stage and measure the apparent length from O to O1, how much it is. So after you measure this distance, keep one end of the compass here and try to cut an arc on the locus of O1. So it will meet somewhere. So this is O1. So this is the locus of O1. So it meets somewhere. Okay, so where it meets, immediately you name it as O. Okay, so O and O1. So this is the previous true length, O to O1. So this is the apparent length from O to O1. So once you got the apparent length O to O1, please name it immediately, or else you get confused. So after naming the apparent length, you kindly extend this line above to our XY line. So where it meets, so that angle will provide you beta, how much it is. In this case, beta it is showing 45 degrees. So please draw a box and write beta is equal to 45 degrees. So after construction of the beta angle, so now you have to reconstruct the entire top view of the second stage to the beta angle inclination. So the procedure is the same to reconstruct as I told you in the previous. So what you do is, first you complete the bottom surface. So bottom surface, so this is O1. So you need all the five corners, right? You know only the center point O1. So how you will proceed? Just draw a perpendicular line. Okay, so through O1, you just draw a perpendicular line. After drawing perpendicular line, you measure from O1 to E1, what is the distance, using compass. Keep one end of the compass here and cut an arc on this perpendicular line. Similarly, you have the perpendicular line what you have drawn backside also. So you measure from O1 to B, what is the distance. Keep one end of the compass here and just cut an arc. So you will get the point B1 and E1. So this is done. So now, again, you need the remaining four corners. So now what you do is, from O1 to this midpoint, you find out what is the distance. Keep one end of the compass here and just make a reference point. Just put a dot. And again, from O1 to this point, what is the distance? You refer using a compass. And here again, on the perpendicular line, from this one end of the compass here, and just make a reference point. So you've got two points here, one here and the other one here. So from these two points, you just draw a perpendicular line and extend it. You can extend also, because anyhow we need for this part, just extend the perpendicular line. After you got the perpendicular line, come back here at the bottom surface, keep one end of the compass here and measure this distance how much it is, and go to the third stage, keep one end of the compass here and cut an arc on the perpendicular line what you drew before. Similarly, here also you have drawn the perpendicular line. So you will measure this distance from this midpoint to this how much it is and just cut an arc on the perpendicular line. So you got the corners now D1 and C1 and you know E1 and B1. So these two are needed. This is also simple. You have the projection line drawn already. So you please measure, both will be same. So from the midpoint to F1, from the midpoint to A1, you measure the distance. Again, come back to the third stage, keep one end of the compass here and cut an arc on this perpendicular line. Again, keep one end of the compass here and cut an arc. So you got F1 and A1 also. So once you got all these corners, so you just join A from A1 to B1, B1 to C1, C1 to D1, D1 to E1 and E1 to F1. So this will get you the bottom surface, but be careful, don't draw all the sides continuous. You have to see which sides are hidden, kindly draw it hidden line only right away, and the remaining sides which are visible, kindly draw it. So once the bottom surface is done, please take the projections. Okay, so draw the projection from E1, and this you have drawn already. You can extend it if it is not bigger. So extend this line and extend this line also. You have this O1 fixed already, right? So from O1, you can just draw a perpendicular line as you did for the bottom surface. So once you draw the perpendicular line, you can measure this distance O to F how much it is, and you just cut an arc. And similarly from O to B how much it is, you can just cut an arc. Okay, so then you will get these two corners. So after these, you get these two corners. You can join here from E1 to E, from B1 to B. Okay, so this line you have drawn already, the projection line. So from on this projection line, what you have drawn, you just measure from A1 to A, what is the distance? You have this point A1 with you. So from A1 dash to A, what is the distance? Keep one end of the compass here and cut an arc. Similarly from this point to this, from F1 dash to F, what is the distance? Keep one end of the compass here and cut an arc. So you got the points F, A, E, B. You need to get these two points. So you can either measure from this end to this or from this end to this, whichever is convenient to you. You have both the points. So if you measure from F1 dash to this point how much it is, you can keep one end of the compass here and just cut an arc. And again, from you can keep one end of the compass here and measure this distance and you can just cut an arc. So you'll get the point D and C also. So after you get the points, you know that the top surface is continuous and visible. Because the top surface is visible, so you'll draw a continuous line. So please darken the top surface. Bottom surface we have completed already with three sides visible and three sides hidden. And remaining longer edges, you just join it. So all these are visible edges. So join here from E1 to E, from G1 to D, from C1 to C, and from B1 to B. So we now shifted the second stage, top view of the hexagonal prism to the given inclination of the angle beta. So once this is done, our work now is to take the projections up. Be careful, you'll get very narrow lines. If you don't draw parallel lines, it gets inclined and you get crooked lines. Use the scale and draw parallel lines properly. Every point will be very much near to each other. So please take the projection from each points, from A1, B1, C1, D1, E1, F1. Similarly, you take the projections from A, B, C, D, E and F. Also, please take the projection from O as well as O1. So once you take the projection from each corner of the top view, kindly take the projection from each point from the front view also. So C1 dash and D1 dash, B1 dash and E1 dash, C1 dash and D1 dash, B1 dash and B1 dash and E1 dash, A1 dash and F1 dash. So these are just C dash and D dash. This is B dash and E dash, and this is A dash and F dash. So these are the projections of top and the bottom surface. Just a second. Hello, hello, sir. Yeah, I'm in class, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So after this, you will just take the projections, right? So after you take the projections from the front view and the top view, you see the locus. So you have the locus of E1 is meeting E1 dash at this point. So this is our E dash, and you have locus of D and meeting D1 dash at this point. So this is our D dash, and you have the locus of F1 is meeting F1 dash at this point, and you have the locus of A1, and A1 dash is meeting at this point, so this is our A1 dash, and the locus of B1 is meeting B1 dash at this point, and the locus of C1 is meeting C1 dash at this point, and the locus of D1 is meeting D1 dash at this point. So we got all the surfaces of the bottom. Similarly, we have to join the top surface also. So you please read the locus. So you have the locus of A and A dash here, and locus of B and B dash here, and locus of F and F dash here, and locus of E and E dash over here, locus of D and D dash over here, and locus of C and C dash. So we got the namings for the top surface also. So once you get the namings of the top and the bottom surface, the next step is to take the projections from the center, from the top and the bottom. So this is O1. So when you take the projection, O1 is meeting with O1 dash at this point. So name it as O1 dash. And O is meeting O1 dash at this point. So name this as O dash. Outer boundary will be always visible. So you can join from A1 dash to A dash, A dash to B dash, B dash to C dash, C dash to D dash. From there, D dash to D1 dash, D1 dash to E1 dash, E1 dash to F1 dash, F1 dash to A1 dash. So outer boundary is visible. So after that, the observer is viewing from here. So when he views from here, this surface will be visible. So you will darken this surface continuously. So this you have darkened already. The remaining three sides you please darken. D1 dash to C1 dash, C1 dash to yes, it is C1 dash to B1 dash and B1 dash to A1 dash. So we darken the surface here, which is visible. And once you darken the surface which is visible, I told you that the projection coming through the corner is continuous. The projection coming through the top surface of the prism will be visible. So the projection now from C1 dash to C dash you will join as it is visible, and projection of B1 dash to B dash you will join, and this will be visible. This boundary we have darkened already. So apart from that, we have the projections which is coming through inside the surface. So these projections will be hidden. So you will make hidden line E1 dash to E dash, F1 dash to F dash as hidden. So apart from these, you have the points connected to the other small edges of the base also. Since this is hidden, the projection coming from the hidden line will be hidden only. So here F dash to A dash will be hidden, and again E dash to D dash will be hidden. Means the back two rectangular surfaces and three base edges will be not visible. So when it is inclined in this position, these three surfaces will be visible, and these back surfaces, okay, so this will be hidden. So the projection coming through the back surfaces from these three corners also will be hidden. So that's what being shown here. So that you can map with respect to the hidden lines what you have drawn for cross-checking purpose, or else it's not needed. Only one side I will show you, the remaining thing is the same. So yeah, the projection is E dash. So E dash e1 e1 so projection coming through the e1 is hidden, so but it comes through the outer boundary here. E1 to d1 is outer boundary, e1 to f1 is outer boundary, so you cannot show it as hidden. But you have one more projection coming from e1 to e1 dash through inside the surface, so that will be applicable for hidden. Similarly, if you take e1 to f1, even this point is hidden, so through f1 the projections which are coming lies on the outer boundary. F1 dash to A1 dash is outer boundary. F1 dash to E1 dash is also outer boundary. So you cannot show hidden line. But you have one more projection which is coming through inside the top surface. And as a result, F1 dash to F will be hidden. Okay, so in this way, you have to cross check whether you have done the hidden lines properly or not. So this is about the problem how you have to solve if it is an hexagonal prism where the axis is inclined to VP directly. If it is appears to be, then we will solve the problem as in the previous case where we directly shift the apparent length to the given inclination to VP, where beta angle determination is not needed. Only if the axis is inclined directly, then you have to determine the beta angle. If they tell the axis is inclined to one of the side in which it was resting, so then it is not a beta angle problem because the true length of the side in the first stage and the second stage remains the same. So we will directly just incline the given side to the inclination. Okay, so no apparent angle will be given. So this is the thing how it has to be solved when the given axis, okay, so this problem is resting on one of its corner. So what happens over here? So it is an hexagonal prism of 25 mm side of base and 50 mm axis length, which rests on HP on one of its corner of the base, such that the two base edges containing the corner on which it rests makes equal inclination with HP. So this is a problem how it rests when it is resting on one of its corner. So if you have an hexagonal prism, okay, if you have an hexagonal prism, if it is resting on one of its corner on HP, so you have to assign in such a way that it is not resting on one of its edge. So you have to rotate in such a way that the corner you are keeping towards your right. So if you keep one of the corner towards your right, the other corner will be deadly opposite to it. Okay, in case of pentagon, you used to have one side and one corner opposite. Since it is six sides, if you focus resting on corner, so opposite side also you'll be having other corner only. So how you place it? If it is resting on one of its side, then you always keep the side towards your right, so that opposite side also you'll be having the same side or the edge. So when it is resting on one of its corner, when you view, so you will be having the two corners focused. So one towards your right and other towards your left. So your remaining part will be your hexagonal surface. So when you turn the horizontal surface down, so you will have the true shape of the hexagon in this way when it is resting in one of its corner, because you keep the corner towards your right. So if you keep resting on one of its edge, the top view looks like this, where you rest, where you keep the side towards your right. So you'll be having the opposite side or the edge here. If it is resting in one of its corner, you will keep the corner towards your right and you will be having the other corner opposite to it. And similarly, these two sides will be making equal inclinations with HP because it will be resting on HP. So when it is resting on HP, so this will be the corner in which it will be resting, and these two sides will be making equal inclinations with respect to HP. So that you have to take care. So this is how the position of the given hexagonal prism looks like. So this problem I will take care in the next class. Okay, so currently you see that you solve the problems exactly, and you should be aware how the position of the given prism looks like. So whether it is in solid, whether it's in square prism, a pentagon or an hexagonal prism, you have to be thorough in identifying the first stage. How does it looks? Whether it is resting in one of its corner or one of its face. If you do the first position properly, so then you won't go wrong in the second and the third stage, provide you take the projection parallel lines properly and do the namings of the corner and understand the concepts of which are visible and which are hidden. Okay, so I will just share the problems to be solved in the sketchbook. Kindly complete all the pending works until now. Many have submitted the problems. You please start submitting the problems on square prism as the due date is approaching. Please keep it on time. I will just share the videos related to the pentagonal prisms as well as the hexagonal prisms and how to operate in solid edge. I have done the recording already. I will share you hopefully by today. So if you have any doubts, you are free to speak on. So remaining problems related to how it has been rested with respect to HP in one of its corner. So that I will take care in the next class. If time permits, I will share the videos for those problems also. So now you can speak up if you have any doubts or if you need any clarity on it. Purneshwari, you are here. Hello.
Yes,
hope the concept of how to solve the problem on hexagonal prism was been understood. Okay, so I will just share the videos also related to that. So kindly go through it. If you have any doubts in understanding, kindly speak up. Mohammed, you are here.
Yes. Hello.
Yeah. Was the problem visible? The concept was understood. Hello. Yeah, solid edge. You should practice in solid edge also. I will share the videos related to that. How to solve the problems. Please try one of the problems related to planes and solids whenever you get time. Did you people install the software in your desktop or laptop? Hello. You people have not installed yet? If no, kindly let me know. No, not a problem. No need to hesitate. But I told you long back for you all to install it. Did you try anyone at least? Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, please tell me, Praneet.
Ma'am, you have sent only how to install the video, ma'am. So how to install the software?
No. Yeah, there is a Google Drive which has many folders in it. Okay, so out of those folders, one folder speaks about the video, how to install. So there is a setup file, everything which has been shared. So you please go through it. It is not a single folder which is there. If you don't have, I will reshare it. I have shared, I think, twice to thrice.
No, ma'am. No, that is not what I asked, ma'am. How to download the setup files, ma'am?
It is there in the Google Drive.
Okay, ma'am. I'll go through.
I have shared a Google Drive link in the Google Classroom, I think, in the month of April and... So that Google Drive, if you click, it has many folders. You have a folder for setup file. You have a particular folder about a video, how to install. Okay. So that you please go through it and try to install it.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
And the problems related to the solids, you people have not turned up yet in the Google Classroom. Please to submit. Everything should be completed within this month. We have 15 days in hand. So don't delay it. Whenever you find time, complete and submit so that I can evaluate and regrade the marks for you all. Okay. Namrita?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Did you install it?
Yes, ma'am, I've installed it.
Okay. So did you try solving some problems on it? Did you brush up the tools?
Ma'am, I didn't solve any problem, but I saw the tools and all that.
Okay. Because you have done at least problems on points and lines, right? So at least you'll be aware of the tools, which tools to be used how. So just give a try for the problems what you have solved in the sketchbook. Just a try. So one problem might be a wrong. Second, you will get used to how to do it. I am showing the varieties of the problems in solids. One in square prism, one is pentagonal prism, like that. One in hexagonal prism. So the concepts will be the same for other types. I cannot do for all the problems and show